greetings from the very presence of the Most High God, the one who created you and I, the one who causes the sun to shine every day and the rain to also fall every day, the one who gives us sunlight, the one who gives us nightlight, the moon. It is the same God who does all for us, even those who deny that he is real. God still allows you to live, and he gives you air to breathe. And we give him glory tonight for his goodness and for his loving kindness. Hallelujah. 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 Amen. Amen. Lord of all beings, throne
Oh,
is Jesus Christ himself, he found a way. Amen. He always finds a way to save every one of us. The vilest of the sinners, he saves and sets free. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
My heart was distressed.
Thank you.
God. Amen.
Amen.
The Lord is good.
All the time.
The Lord is good.
All the time.
Jesus Christ is good.
All the time.
Let us hear it on top of your voice. Jesus Christ is good.
All the time.
Jesus Christ is good.
All the time.
Jesus Christ is good.
All the time.
Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the living God. The Lord is good. Amen. The word of God says, John chapter 14 and verse 6, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. Jesus Christ is the only way. Jesus Christ is the only truth. And Jesus Christ is the only life. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Christianity is not a religion. Christianity is life. Because Jesus Christ is life. You don't become a Christian by going to church. You become a Christian by receiving Jesus Christ into your heart as your Lord and personal Savior. Hallelujah. That is what separates Christianity from every other. Christianity is life. If you have Jesus Christ in your life or in your heart, you have life. Jesus Christ said, I came that you might have life and have it more abundantly. Satan came to steal and kill and destroy. Religions come, or they came, to steal, kill, and to destroy. But Jesus Christ came that you and I will have life and have it more abundantly. My beloved brother and sister, wherever you are tonight, if you don't know Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior, my beloved, you have no life. Now, when I talk about life, I'm not talking about the kind of life that most of us think it's actually life. When I tell you, go and get a life. I have life because I go to the beer bar or to the alcoholic beverage store. Or I go to those wild parties that we organize on Friday evenings or Saturday night. That is not life. Because the end of that is death, is destruction. It's a kind of life devoid of the true life. But tonight, Jesus Christ wants me to let every one of us know that He is the only way, and He is the only truth, and He is the only life. We don't need to spend trillions of dollars researching outer space to see if there's life there and to find out how they exist so we can transfer it down on Earth. We don't need to. Because God's word says that He is very close by your side. So we don't need to waste resources researching outer space saying that we are going to look for a source of life. When we cannot manage what we have here on earth, we are destroying everything that we have here on earth, polluting every one of them. And we are going into outer space to pollute that place also. It won't happen. Jesus Christ is right by your side tonight. If you only open your heart, He will come into you and He will give you life. Jesus Christ tonight wants to give you life, the true life. As I explained at the very beginning, Christianity is not a religion. It is life. And without Jesus Christ in your heart, you have no life, my beloved. No wonder so many of us are so chaos. I mean, we are going through chaos in our lives. Men don't know if they are men. Women don't know if they are women. That is confusion because you don't have the one who created you in your life. You don't have Jesus. And if you don't have Jesus Christ in your life, you are in a crisis. You are in a state of confusion. Because you don't know whether you are a man, you don't know whether you are a woman, you know, and you don't know if you are a human being, Because some have settled, because you are so confused, we find an animal, we think the animal is a human being, so you get married to an animal. Because you don't have Jesus Christ in your life. You have no life. You are confused. But tonight, Jesus Christ is saying, if you only open your heart and let him enter your heart, you will find life, true life. And you begin to understand the reason why you were created. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. As we near the day that we call Independence, or July 4th, Independence Day, it is my prayer tonight that you give yourself the greatest gift on Independence Day. That is giving your life to Jesus Christ. The only one who can break the yoke of dependence on Satan, he will break that yoke and set you free. The word of God tells us in the book of John chapter 3. It says that if the Son shall set you free, you shall be free indeed. It is only Jesus Christ that sets us free. And when Jesus Christ sets you free from the bondages and the ravages of sin, you will have life. And you begin to have a deep sense of wanting to live. My beloved, don't let this moment pass you by. Jesus Christ came into this world, died on the cross of Calvary, purposely so that he will give you life, so you will have life and have it more abundantly. Too many of us, most of us today, are still in bondage. Nations are in bondage. They claim they are independent. But independent from what? We are independent, but we are dependent on drugs, dependent on Satan, dependent on demonic forces, dependent on powers that don't come from God. In the book of Isaiah 30 and 31, woe unto those nations that go into Egypt to seek for a covering, for a power that is not of me. And that is our world today. Our source of strength and power is from the devil, Lucifer. He has become our idol and our God that we worship. But tonight, Jesus Christ offers you the true life. He says, I came and died at Calvary, shed my blood, so that you be free from dependency on the devil, dependency on Satan, become independent, and set, he wants to set you free and give you life, that you may have life abundantly. Beloved, would you give your life to Jesus Christ tonight so that you can enter into July 4th with a great assurance of knowing that you are indeed truly free, that you have been set free from the power of sin, you have been set free from the power of the devil, you have been set free from any and everything that encroaches on your soul? Jesus Christ is the only one who offers us that. No politician can offer you any salvation or any freedom or any independence. They themselves are in bondage. So they have to lie. Most of them will have to lie and lie and lie because their dependence is on you. But my beloved, tonight I want you to shake off the shackles. Shake off those shackles. Jesus Christ wants to set you free. He wants to give you life more abundantly tonight. If only you open your heart. If only you admit the fact that you are a sinner. Stop the life of hypocrisy, because it will not help you. As I said, going to church does not make you a Christian. No. Going to church does not make you a Christian. Going to McDonald's to buy hamburger does not make you a hamburger. And going to Texas fried chicken doesn't make you a chicken, a fried chicken. In the same way, going to church doesn't make you a Christian. It is when you receive Jesus Christ into your life, and your life is transformed, your heart is changed, you have to become a new man. The book of 1 Corinthians chapter 5, 2 Corinthians 5 and 17. If a man be in Christ, any man be in Christ, he is a new creation. All things have passed away. Behold, all things are becoming new. Have become new. Do you know the reason why we kill each other every day? The moment you turn on the news, somebody has shot somebody dead, it's because we don't have Jesus Christ in our life. We have not been born again. We don't have Christ in our life. And because we don't have the Christ in our life, we are in a crisis. And anybody is in a crisis, in a state of confusion. And all that you do is things that you do when the devil whispers into your ears. So he says, take a gun and shoot somebody, take a gun and shoot him. That is what we are. We are a people living in crisis. Not until Jesus Christ comes to live in our lives, in our hearts, and changes our lives and gives us the true life. The true life comes from Jesus. No other person gives you the true life. All the other religions are just that. They are religion. The people who founded those religions are dead, and their bones are still in the grave. But Jesus Christ, who is life, when he was crucified, he was buried, he rose again on the third day. He is seated on the right-hand side of the Father. It is only Jesus' blood that washes away sin. None of the others who claim to be whatever they are, none of them, they have shed any blood for any person. So who would you follow? The person who is dead and his bones are still in the grave? Whose followers go every year to go and look at the bones in the grave? Or the one who died and rose again from the dead and is seated on the right-hand side of God Almighty, who is constantly pleading your case before God? Who would you follow? He is the only one who gives life, Jesus Christ. My beloved, tonight, I want to encourage you. Look to Jesus Christ for your redemption. Look to Jesus Christ for your salvation. Your life has to be transformed. Your life has to be changed. So many are in a state of crisis. In a crisis state, no joy, no peace in your life. Every single day you have to have your alcoholic, you ought to drink wine so that you get drunk, so you don't remember your woes anymore. But then you wake up and your woes are still with you. My beloved, you wake up and your woes are still with you. How can this be life? But there is one person, Jesus Christ. He says this, come unto me, all you who labor and are of heavy burden. All you who are laboring and are of heavy burden. The burden of confusion, of crisis. The burden of a state of chaos. In a chaotic condition, your mind is almost like a scrambled egg. There's no peace in your head, no peace in your life. You are contemplating committing suicide because you feel like life is hopeless. My beloved, you don't have to commit suicide. There is one who is standing right by your side. He said, I died for you. I shed my blood for you. And I'm willing to set you free. And I'm willing to restore unto you the joy and the peace of my salvation. It is free of charge, my beloved. Jesus Christ died to set you and I free. You don't have to pay a dime for it. That is why on our crusade ground here, we don't take offering, because your soul is more important than a dollar or a dime. Jesus Christ wants to set your soul free. You don't have to pay any money for it. All you need to do is to say, yes, I have sinned. I am a sinner. I need Jesus Christ in my life. Surrender your life to him. And you find how good and how sweet it is to know Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior. It is my prayer tonight, my beloved, that you enter into this weekend, having been free from the shackles of sin, having been free from the power of sin. As I said earlier on, without Jesus Christ, you are in a state of hopelessness, helplessness, confusion, and crisis. That is why you have people walking around arguing whether they don't know whether they are a male or female. A man wants to change his gender. He's confused. He says, I feel like a man, but I am a man in a woman's body. Who told you that? It is Satan whispering into your ears. Because Satan's desire has always to alter and counter whatever God has instituted. So he makes you think that way. Because you don't have Jesus in your life. You are in a state of confusion. There's a crisis in your life. But tonight, someone stands right by your side. He wants to set you free. He wants to set you free. Jesus Christ says, my peace that exceeds all understanding is what I'll give to you. If you give your life to him, in the book of Isaiah chapter 30, it says, in returning and rest, you will have peace in your life. My beloved, why don't you return and come to Jesus? He wants you to return and come to him. Return. Stop wandering and wallowing in sin. Stop wandering in the world. Stop researching. There is no need for you to research for anything because there is no answer in any of the things. You will not find out. You will not find anything. Everything, whenever you plant yourself into researching, you keep on researching and researching until Jesus comes. All he needs you to do is to listen to that small voice. That voice of the Spirit of God that is saying, come unto me, my beloved. Come with your burden. Come with your yoke. For I died for you, and I'm more than willing to break those yokes, the shackles, and to set you free. Would you come to Jesus Christ tonight? My beloved, it is free. There is only one person who will tell you you don't need to go. And that person is Satan. Satan does not want you to be free because he wants you to spend eternity with him in hell. Hell is real. And hell is for every stubborn person that continues to harden his heart and his neck and refuses to repent, who walks with his hands in the cloud thinking that there is no God. My friend, don't think that way. Because one day you wake up and have a shock of your life. When you stand before God and you say, wow, God, I didn't know. I was denying you all this time. But that will be too late. You cannot repent. The Bible says, it is appointed unto man once to die. After that, the judgment. There are some who make you think that there is something called reincarnation. When you die, you become a mouse in the next life. Or when you die, you become this and that. Ask all of those people. How many of them can identify themselves in the mouse or the lizard world? How can you believe such a confused thing? Somebody tells you when you die, you become a cow, and you believe it. And so you follow them. And so they will not eat cow because they think perhaps they are eating their grandfather or grandmama. My beloved, Jesus Christ is real. Tonight, give your life to him. There is no reincarnation. There is nothing like reincarnation. It is appointed unto man once to die. After that, there is the judgment. And we shall all appear before the judgment seat of Christ. Whether you are a president, a senator, a congressman, an army general, secretary of state, whatever you are, we shall all appear before the judgment seat of Christ. And the beautiful thing about it is that on that day of judgment, you will not come there saying, because I was the president, I should be treated better than everybody else. No, there is no respect of persons with God on that day. That is why every one of us have to humble ourselves and turn from our wicked ways and yield our lives to Jesus Christ. Because on that day, so many will be gnashing their teeth. They'll be saying, had I known, I wish. But had I known, it's always at last. Had I known, it's always at the point where you cannot go back. Do you want to do that? There is no point of return. When you die, that is it. When you die in your sin, that is it. That is it. It's a moment of hopelessness and helplessness. Nobody can pray for you to get out of where they call that place. There is going to be a holding place where somebody can pray for you. No, there's no holding place. There's no holding place. And no one can pray you out of hell. When you die in your sin, hell is where you're going to be permanently. So many of us are complaining today that it is too hot. 91 degrees hot. Well, where could you go to hell? Because hell is 1,000 times hotter now. Then it is hotter than today. And there is no water. There will be no water bottles there. There will be no water in hell, my beloved. Hell is real. That is what so many of us don't want to hear, but it is real. Hell is real. And hell is made for Satan. And everyone who believes in Satan and follows Satan will follow him to hell. Jesus came to die, to set you free, so that you will not go to hell. He wants to give you life, eternal life. Heaven is filled with eternal life. Some are saying, well, let us drink, let us have party. Because when we go to hell, there's going to be party over there. We'll meet Michael Jackson, James Brown, everybody, and we shall have party. Suit yourself. It is so hot that even the instruments will melt. They will not even have time to say they are going to play, my beloved. In hell, there's not going to be any entertainment. All that you, the music they'll be singing is water, 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 because they are so thirsty and they are looking for water. Repent from your sin tonight. Give your life to Jesus Christ and you will not go to hell. Jesus Christ came that you may have life and have it more abundantly. Would you receive him into your life tonight? Would you receive Jesus Christ into your life tonight? He is standing right at the door of your heart. Your being here tonight is not by accident. It's by divine ordination. God has ordained this moment that you be here. So that you hear his word. So that you be saved and set free from the power of the devil. That lying demon. Who constantly is lying and whispering to the ears of people. My beloved, run from the devil. Run from Satan. And run for your life, because your life depends on it. Hallelujah. Jesus Christ is tenderly calling today. Who will hear? Jesus Christ is tenderly calling today. Who will listen? Jesus Christ is tenderly calling today. Who will hear? Jesus Christ is tenderly calling today. Would you give your life to him? Jesus is tenderly calling today, calling today, calling today. Why from the sunshine of joy will that roll? Father and farther away. Announcements. But before she comes, I want to let you know, as she is coming, July 6th, Jess Postel. That is next week, Saturday, Jess Postel, Jesus People Celebration. Begins at 3 o'clock, prompt. So please tell your friends, come and let us celebrate Jesus Christ.
Grace and peace. My God, my God, my God. Truly, your servant has given the word tonight as you have given him. We do give you praise. We give you honor. We magnify you. We pray, dear Heavenly Father, this week we will become independent of your Son, Jesus Christ, that will depend on him and him only. We pray, dear Heavenly Father, that they will have ringing in the ear, I am the way, the truth, and the life. That's what Jesus said. We are so glad, dear Heavenly Father, to be out here tonight. Have this opportunity, dear Heavenly Father, to tell the people the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ. We pray, dear Heavenly Father, that this will ring in their ears, O God, until they surrender their lives to you. We thank you, dear Heavenly Father, we have this spot on this land, O God, to do this every week, to come and let people know that the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. We pray, dear Heavenly Father, that those that have accepted you tonight, we pray, dear Heavenly Father, they grow in grace and in the knowledge of Jesus. We pray, dear Heavenly Father, for those that do not know you and just refuse to come, trouble their hearts, oh God, trouble their hearts. In the precious name of Jesus, we do ask these blessings and for our sake. Amen.
Grace and Peace Pyramids Village. It's been a delight to be with you again tonight. And we want to invite you to our services. You've heard the word of God. We want you to continue to hear the word of God and to join fellowship with us. We are a friendly group here, and you can come and have lively worship service with us. We have the Sunday school on every Sunday at 9:30. Then we have the morning worship service at 10:45. We have Bible study on Wednesday, and we back out here on Friday night for the outdoor crusade. We invite you to come to celebrate with us the Lord Jesus Christ. You've heard the word of God. Jesus is alive. Jesus is alive. Come and join us. We welcome you in Jesus' name. Amen. And may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore.